I'm creating WordPress theme and plugins. And right now I would like to share my experience how to speed up and optimize WordPress site. Because I'm sharing my experience, I can say about myself why I need to do this. Because I creating WordPress theme, I can create smart looking theme, create wonderful content, but if it's my website loading very slow, visitors will not wait and just close it. The second reason and the main reason that Google gives top results for fast websites, and if my website is slow, Google may not show it at all. So Google has this tool, web page page speed inside its address, and this tool allow you to check how optimized and how speed your website. So sorry, I hide personal data. And here, with red, you type your website and then press analyze button. After that, you will get results. You see that this website is very, very bad because it has only 18 points from 100 for mobile optimization, and 0 points for desktop. But this tool not only show you results, but it also give you suggestion what to do. First, it suggests to reduce server response time, but it's the question to your hoster. The next optimization suggestion is optimize images. And you will see that if I optimize images and can get 88% of reduction. So if you have a landing page, you can just download optimized images from web page inside, but if you uploading images very often, you can get another way. Sorry. So I use a Smash Image Compression Optimization plugin to optimize my images. I show how plugin looks in a repository page that you can easily find and recognize it. After you install and activate this plugin, you will get Smash menu in admin page, and you will see that my images already optimized, and I have only one image for optimization. So you can press bulk optimization. So, for example, my friend had 6,000 images on her website. So not necessary to optimize image by image, just to use this button. In the settings, I recommend set on automatically optimize images during uploading. So when you upload your image to your website, not necessary to think how to optimize. Before, I used Photoshop to optimize my images for web, and I was surprised that this plugin does it better than Photoshop. So, but if you don't want to do this, to use automatically optimization, you may disable this option. So in a free version, you can choose which images you wish to optimize. So the next option, stripe image metadata. If you are a photographer, you need to keep your data about camera on your images. But if you're not a photographer, not necessary to keep them, and you may just stripe it. After you set up this plugin, you just press save options. As I said before, if you don't want to do bulk optimization, you can smash images by images. So go to media library, choose an image, and you will get a smash button. Next, tips from page insights. It asked to remove random blocking JavaScript content and optimize stylesheet delivery. Next, it asked to minify stylesheets and minify JavaScript. And next, it said that ask leverage browser caching. Why I show all these tips together? Because next few plugins I will describe, they do almost all these things. First plugin, V3 Total Cache. It's very complicated plugin. So pay attention that, for example, in gender settings, it has page cache, minified tabs, and they are different from with page cache and minify menu items. Because in general settings, you just enable or disable minifying or caching. First of all, when you are working on working live site, necessary to enable preview mode. After you finish setup with the total cache, you may disable it. Next, we need to enable page cache. And after we enable page cache, we can choose cache method. If you know that you have dedicated server, just use setting for it. But most of us use shared hosting, so it is recommended to use disk enhanced method. So next we will enable minifying option. But when we tick on this option, we will get pop-up message about that it will may malfunctions may occur on your website. So in this, it's recommended to disable preview mode, save all settings, and check how your website works. It really malfunctions occurred. It is necessary first check to manual method. I will describe how to set up manual method later. But if you switch to manual method and your website still has malfunctions, so just off these settings and use another plugin like Auto Optimize or Cloudflare. So next option is data cache and object cache. It's to be honest, they are not recommended to use, but you can check with your website, because right now even shared hostings has fastest database, and if you enable database cache, you may slow down your website. And also, if you enable object cache, you may speed up your website, but in this case, probably your admin page will work slowly. Next, as if you remember, page speed insight suggested to leverage browser caching. So if I get this message that means that browser cache was disabled. So just enable it. I'll skip next options because I have share hosting and they are not sorry. I don't have it. Okay, it was general settings. Go to page cache menu. Most of settings are by default. Just pay attention. If you have a security certificate, just tick on cache SSL settings. So cache preload, tick off on automatically. Automatically prime the page cache and preload the post cache upon publish events. And don't forget to mention your sitemap URL. Next, minify option. You may enable HTML option and inline CSS and JS into HTML. As I said before, if you set minifying option to auto, you will see this page. If it doesn't work or malfunctions still occur on your web page, you may choose not minify but combine only mode. But if you enable manual mode, so you will get these settings on minifying menu. What to do? What's the difference? You will get JavaScript file management. Add a script. Press add a script button, and you'll get a file URI. Where to get this file URI? Go to page inside, and it will show which JavaScript block in your content. Just copy that URI and paste here. And I recommend to embed it before body. That means it's after footer, but before HTML closes. The same situation with CSS minifying. If you use auto mode, you will get CSS file management. Also press the style sheet button and copy and paste CSS, which you need to optimize delivery and verify it. Next, browser cache. Just pay attention for these options. But as I said before, that with three total cache is very complicated plugin. And the next plugin, fastest cache, is really simple because it has only one setting page in free version. It allows you to enable cache system, enable minifying. You can minify HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, but pay attention that you cannot optimize JavaScript delivery and you cannot optimize CSS delivery. So, but probably you use modern SEM that allows you to do this. Next, plugin. I already mentioned it when I talked about minifying in with three total cache. If you have malfunctions, you should disable it and use this plugin. So you will see hide advanced settings button, but when you should press it to show advanced settings. So you can, this plugin allows you to optimize HTML code, optimize JSS, and optimize style sheets. Next plugin, Page Speed Ninja. It's very tempting to use it because creators promise to fix all page speed insights issues with one click. Definitely it's possible because they have presets and you can use one preset and check how your website will work and how it will optimize it. So after you choose a preset, you may customize it. For example, because I'm using Smash for image optimization, I disabled image optimization in this plugin. But this plugin doesn't work properly with any sites. On the plugin page, you will find a link where you can check your website. Is it possible to optimize your website with this plugin? Also, it doesn't work properly with some plugins. For example, WooCommerce doesn't work with this plugin. Next, you will see results for my own website. And I hope you will agree with me that it's not the results that better to work, not good results. Next, I use high resolution images on my homepage, and this plugin changed my featured images with thumbnail images. Okay, I understand that thumbnail images are smaller, lighter, but this is not the result that I expected. And the last straw was that this plugin creates its folder not in plugin directory. And the user doesn't have rights to delete this directory. So I had to request to my hoster to help me to delete it. And the plugins I described before, they directly fix page insight issues. Next two plugins also help to speed up WordPress site. For example, you know that when WordPress rendering your web page, it sends requests to database. And if your database is fast, so WordPress will get results faster and rendering faster. So this plugin allow you to keep database fast. Easy to use. You just tick on that option that you need and run optimization. But pay attention that there's notice that you should do database backup before you do the optimization. As you can see, I do not use schedule and do it manually. And even I have a small website with small database, this plugin will allow me to save more than 10% of its size. But in settings, you can set schedule. Next plugin is plugin organizing. When you are using plugins, you don't know in which order they are loading. And probably you have related post plugin, which should be rendered only on post page, and not necessary to render it on home page. Or you are using contact form that should be loading only on contact page form page. So this plugin will show you order in which plugins are loading, and you can change the loading order. So just also pay attention. You should understand what I'm doing, and there's warning about this. But again, you can change and check if it doesn't help or your website work slowly than before, you can return the options back. So as I said, I'm using related posts and not necessary to load it on homepage. So I just drag and drop where I need it. Probably after that you wonder which results I have now on my web site after all these manipulations. So I have 85 on mobile version and 93 on desktop version. You will see that I have still room to improve, and I know what to do and why I get these results. Thank you for attention.